Welcome to a ProSplit lesson from Pixel Film Studios. ProSplit allows Final Cut Pro X users to split open their clip to reveal a logo, title, or another video. This is a great effect for infomercials or title credit sequences. Users simply have to place a ProSplit layer above their media in the timeline. Customize the look, and ProSplit will do the rest. Let's begin by selecting a video clip or image from the FCPX media library and dragging it to the timeline. Once you have your video in place, go to the FCPX titles library to locate the ProSplit presets. Scan through the split effects and select the one that creates the look you want. Then, drag the adjustment layer above your clip in the Final Cut Pro X timeline. For this example, we will use a preset with a drop zone placeholder. Drag the ends of the title layer to where you want the effect to start and end in the timeline. Next, go to FCPX Media Library and select an image or video to use as the revealed media. Drag the image into the timeline beneath the split media layer and make it the same length. Once everything is lined up perfectly, you need to compound the video clip by itself. This is a strange but necessary step since the 10.6 update to FCPX. Select the ProSplit adjustment layer and go to the inspector window. Click on the drop zone placeholder. Then select the compound clip as close to the beginning as possible and click the blue apply clip button in the FCPX viewer window. Once the media is inside the drop zone, you can discard the clip from the timeline. Now that we have our timeline set up, it's time to customize the orientation of our split. Select the adjustment layer in the timeline and go to the viewer window. Click and grab the center on-screen control to adjust the position of the split animation. Next, use the split distance slider to control how wide you want your image to open up. Then, adjust the split duration slider to change the speed of the animation. Finally, adjust the depth slider to control how much you want the image to zoom in as it splits. Now that we have our split animation set up, let's adjust the look of the media inside the opening. Go to the text property section of the inspector window. Add your title and subtitle to the text fields. Then, use the position and rotation parameters to adjust the orientation of the text. If you would like to adjust the font, size, or color of your titles, you can double-click on them in the viewer to bring up the text parameters in the inspector window. Now for some final touches. Let's fine-tune a few of the style controls to finish off our look. Use the focus blur mount slider to adjust the depth of field between the media layers. Then use the drop shadow controls to separate the layers even more. Since we have a background video instead of a color, we can ignore the BG color gradient. Finally, adjust the shine gradient colors, direction, and blend.